the more people who work closer and closer to nature are more easier, more easily accessible, easily flowing, easily tameable to receptive awareness. So we need to switch back to nature. It is not hard. It doesn't mean that you have to stop wearing the clothes that you're wearing. It just needs to shift the way we operate. The principal direction to this is, can we operate by first moving from a phenomenal paradigm called thinking to feeling? If we can feel, we can feel the pain around us, suffering around us. How do you simplify this? The simplicity comes from understanding the larger picture of life. Just imagine when you are flying over Florida at 40,000 feet, can you actually sense the turmoil in the heads of people here? No, everything looks beautiful. As you come down lower, 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 you start seeing the houses, you start seeing the people moving on the street, and you come at ground level, suddenly you can hear the buzz of life in its turmoil. Just for the reason that we have sent a signal, a thought wave. You getting me? If we are all exchanging thought waves right now, you know, in this room, we are exchanging thought waves. But what is the quality of thought wave? Right now, if you are magnified by the thought I am sending you, you are magnetized by the thought I am sending you, the system inside is changing its template. The template of limitedness to a template of possibility. Template of freedom from simplicity. It takes courage. Nobody gets freedom so easily. Now, what is the simplicity required for that? Simplicity required for that is to first accept. We are not in acceptance. We are in resistance. The sign of resistance shows in the body. You see people how they stand. You see the way their faces are held. You see if they can smile genuinely. I want to see your smile. Show me your smile. Show me if 32. Yes? What has happened to us is, it takes a lot of effort for us to smile from the core of the heart. We smile as if it was a service mistake. It's called occupational hazard. Yes? We have to smile to attract people to us. Yes? Why do we need to attract? Just for a sale? And after that we return back to our depression? Why are we difficult? See, the childlike state is actually within us very strongly. And it is only reflected in our sports. You see people, they become wild when they are in sport. Yes or no? They're actually childlike. Yes? You see all across the world, wherever there's a football match, people are animalistic. Yes? They are so wild, they can fight because for the team. The team players, they don't know that there is a big fight happening over them. Yes? People come alive in sport. They come alive in devotion. If you can shed tears of gratitude, not tears of self-pity. The tears of gratitude, when it flows from here, you are knowing that the child in you is alive. Yes? The child in you is alive. It is pure. See, simple as it. If you want to uncomplicate life, hang around children who are being cultured by nature, not by very pampered environments. Pampered environments, you were demanding. The child is demanding. Put a child, go to those small, small, beautiful villages where children are growing joyfully, organically, one with nature, not in fear mode. You would like to be part of their childhood. Hey, every grandparent looks forward to their nurturing their grandchildren and putting values into the children. Yes? So what is that heart in us which wants to experience? We all want our children, grandchildren to be simple. We want them to be joyful. Yes or not? Don't we nurture that tremendous level of qualitative difference we want to see in them? And yet, we do not provide the right environment for it. We don't provide. We make it difficult. We put a dream. We put a desire. We put a greed. Say, okay, now handle this and try to be simple. Yes? So, we have a complicated environment. Wherever we go, we have nurtured into a complex social economic scenario where societies are all fighting hard to only survival mode. Minute you only rise above the survival mode, can we be happy. But that is very unstable. It is wavering. You can see an oscillometer here, the wavering oscillometer. So simplicity is not guaranteed, because just when you thought you have a simple way of living, your taxman arrives. Yes? So how do we deal with this? So the attitude towards this is, please remember, I'll give you a simple analogy. One man from the west entered into a Himalayan cave. A yogi was sitting there. This man had heavy trekking bag, lots of sweets, protein bars, everything intact, all loaded. He looks at the yogi and says, "Where have you come from?" He says, "This is my home." "Really? There is nothing here inside. You know, there is no furniture, there is nothing." Yogi says, "I am a traveler. Are you?" Yes? If you remember that you are a traveler and passing through this beautiful beam of golden light, passing from the sun into this blue dot which we call as earth, aren't we travelers? But we behave like permanent real estate agents. Yes? So detailed in every occupation, possession. We have written, in India, there's a nice little joke of an ad. There's a old man ready to go up. His whole family has grouped together to sign the check, the will, the amount. What happens? It is one followed by eight zeros. They are very eager for him to sign that. He signs it with great difficulty. He's about to take a ticket to the higher planes. Just a drop of water falls on that one, and the one gets deleted. Now tell me, what will you do with your zeros? So please remember, if the zero comes after one, it has value. If it comes before one, no value. But all we are interested is, remember, we come from zero, return to zero. There's a binary system operating on this world. Zero is stillness, one is movement. Binary system. One is movement, zero is stillness. Don't be scared of zero, because zero means pure magnetism, pulls everything to you. In deep stillness, we are gods. In deep zero, we are gods. The meditative process is to become zero in your thought field. You getting me? But what we are doing, we are trying techniques to become powerful in meditation. We are still at one, not in zero. Because zero, you cannot try to be zero. The beauty of the design is, you can never try to be zero, because zero happens to us. Meditation happens to us. Love happens to us. Zero happens to us. You cannot try to love somebody. If you force it, it will become possession. Yes or no? In the simplicity of love is, it is so subtle. Like a poet in India, an enlightened poet. I won't call him a poet. He was a messenger of God called Kabir. Kabir Das. He made a very phenomenal journey of profound statements that shook up the entire so-called paradigms of religion and all these bifurcations of thinking processes of people. The one statement which I really loved is, he said, "Love is such a narrow passage, there is no room for two." Love is such a narrow passage, there is no room for two. That means if you are in love, you should be one and not two. If you are two, you are complicated. In Facebook, you have a relationship status, complicated. Why are we complicated? Because we don't know anything better. Yes? We found a simple thread. What do you do with a thread? People tie a knot. try or not, my knot is better than yours. Since my knot is better than yours, look, I'm more designer than you. You know, one person came to me. He said he's big. He said, I'm stronger than you. I told him very simple. You have more bacteria than me. Yes? The bacteria and you have grown faster, bigger. You are bigger. The bacteria and me are refusing to grow. I'm still small. So, can we humor ourselves with the understanding this life is a phenomenal joke? Those who don't understand the joke refuse to open their mouth. They cannot even laugh. Yes or no? Look at people, cultures where people have understood the joke are laughing their gut away. People who don't understand the joke go, especially in European sectors. People look like there is almost a gun on their side of their face. Here, a gun is hanging there. If you dare, you open your mouth. It's against your concept. So, the cultures where the understanding is eternal, it's called Sanatana Dharma. Please remember, India is not Hinduism. It is misfortune that people have called it Hindu. It is verbal problem. It's a journey of the way of living. The way of living is called Sanatana Dharma, which means eternal code of life. You can never convert into Hinduism because you are it. Eternal, timeless, deathless. Now tell me what else you want. If you are eternal, do you have to only plan for this life? You know that this is on and on. Right now, planet Earth is our substation. We will move beyond this planet Earth. It's just, you know, I will tell you a larger understanding. Please listen carefully. According to the cosmic time, earthly time is pittance. People said earthly time, they measured and said 4.3 billion years, out of which your 100 years existence is like an unforgettable speck of dot. Now, in this speck of dot, you imagine you have a unsurmountable problem, unsolvable problem. Yes? Such a big problem, whole life you spent in suffering. And for the cosmos, in cosmic time, your entire 100 years is not even a nanosecond. So how many prayers you send to God, the Lord up there? When I say up there, it's everywhere. Just a symbolism that we call it up there. Because what is possible in this understanding is the magnitude of our life in the cosmic span of time is so trivial, so little, it is not even worth mentioning for the cosmos. Oh, you had problem, but you're already out. Weren't you on planet Earth? Sir, I was, but I'm not now. Yes? That means, remember this. All you have to do is eject out your thought field and hover around. Higher, 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 higher. Until you see yourself as a small speck of dot. If you see yourself as a small speck of dot in the vast canvas of this cosmos, is your problem so big? Only the ego massage is constantly required for us to nurture this so-called suffering. Every morning, we are the same bunch of people with a compounded problem. We add on to the problems. We have a huge reference library. We add on problems. So, it's like a medical report that you take with you. Yes? The medical report is not going to get anywhere lesser. You're going to add, sir, your kidney is enlarged. Wow. Really? Ask what's the standard size of a kidney, my dears? Show me the God's manual, designer's manual. Show me the exact size of a kidney. Then I will trust you that this is the only size of the kidney that should be. Yes? The kidneys may shrink or expand. It is got moods. Please remember, there is no manual for our shape and design. We are intricately unique. So unique that we were never meant to be compared or measured. We may eat the same food. Just try this example. Eat this, bring a bunch of people, give them the same food for 1 month and see the difference on them. Give them the same medicine, same drug, the impact is different. The qualitative shift in them is different. That means we are in living in a unique reality. Since if you accept that, you're already simple. The minute you want to measure and compare, there you have started the trajectory of disaster. Yes? Always we are measuring and comparing. All we have is emotions, which have come from thoughts. So thoughts is not ours, but emotion is ours. Yes? Thoughts were never ours. It was passing through. We just dragged it inside us. Wait, let me also. Yes? See, there was a Russian fable which said, a Russian man, a businessman, walks into a very remote area, a tribal area, and meets the tribal lord, you know, the head of them. And he says, wow, such a big land. How much is your land? He says, we can't even measure. It is so big. He says, can I have a small, you know, part of it? He says, take. He says, how much? As much as you walk from morning, breakfast time till afternoon. This guy gets wild. Wow, lottery, jackpot. I am going to walk as fast as I can. Once in a lifetime opportunity. He starts walking. By midday, he becomes greedy. He says, I'm going to make as much as in the whole world can imagine. He starts running. By about 3 o'clock, he is found dead. You getting me? Please remember this. Greed is our killer. In the feast of the greedy, nobody goes home satisfied. So, if we have implanted a greed, have the courage to take a forceps, remove it out, not yours. Yes? But where do we get it from? We were perfectly fine with our car until the neighbor bought a Jaguar. Oh? We were fine till then. Suddenly we felt, suddenly the world is complicated. Life has not been fair to me. Yes? Till now I was fine. The neighbor's car is disturbing me too much. Yes? So, we have this impossible ability to compare and measure. Thoughts, emotions, memories, patterns. We all are living a pattern. We can't disengage from this pattern. The sad part of this is, we are having the impossible ability to transfer this pattern to our children. Genetically transferred. We are transferring it to our friends by infusing fear. Yes? How can fear be multiplied? You see these agony people? They transmit, radiate fear in everywhere. False alarms. So, by end of the day, you have a whole battalion of fear-infested people. You getting me? The fear inside us refuses to go away. We are mortal by fear, immortal by desire. What is the desire inside us? The desire says, you can be the great emperor of this place. You can own everything, possess everything, control everything. Please remember, the minute you try to control, you lose control. What we do in our life? In a little way, everybody are control freaks. See, a man gets battered at office, comes home. All the anger is thrown on the people at home. That's where he is the boss. Yes? We are complicated to a point where we want to control the people in our life. Love is a control game. Power is a control game. Wherever there is power which is absolute, corrupts absolutely.